This one.
Today, young students often carry the feeling that school doesn't apply to the real world. But if they can realize a connection, they develop real incentives to learn and become charged with responsibility. This is the story of the TRAC program.
TRAC is an outreach program to high school students, and we're going into middle schools now too, to try and interest students in the civil engineering and transportation field.
Today's high school students are the designers of the future. For nearly 10 years, the American Association of State Highway and Transportation Officials, known as AASHTO, has proudly sponsored the TRAC program, a creative learning curriculum for high school students. Created in 1991 as a pilot project for improving both the quality and diversity of the professional transportation workforce, AASHTO's TRAC program has proven to be an effective outreach and recruiting tool for women and minorities, two groups who have historically been underrepresented in the field. The TRAC program allows students to work on their own or in pairs. That way, students teach themselves.
Because you can work at your own pace, the entire class won't bring you down or speed up ahead of you, and you can do what you want to do when you want to do it.
I like that better because if a teacher gets too involved, they might try like helping you too much and you don't really learn anything.
And the course syllabus demands attention from students.
In every activity, there is some kind of a math problem for them to use, or a science deduction. Problem solving is in every activity.
The TRAC acronym stands for Transportation Research Activity Center. The entire activity center comes packed in a sturdy suitcase. Inside are project materials, coursework, and numerous instruments, all that a student needs to carry out the experiment. The TRAC pack may be just what a student needs to inspire an important professional career for the future, particularly one in the field of transportation and civil engineering.
Currently, we're in 25 states, and we're also in Puerto Rico, Tanzania, and South Africa.
The program and its method of teaching proved to be a real force in the world of secondary education.
One of the main reasons the TRAC program has been successful, it's been the support of those people that go into the classroom and actually meet one-on-one or in a group setting with the students.
I believe that was you, correct? That's what we're going to do. Now that we have designed and built our town.
The volunteer engineer takes what the students learn in the TRAC pack and what they learn in the schools and actually relate it to everyday civil engineering and transportation projects. My favorite part of the program is going into the high school classrooms and working with the students.
It has something to do with it. I know it does.
Other than that, some of the states are doing internship programs where they bring in some of the better TRAC students and have them work with engineers and transportation professionals over the summer.
Maryland is a state that benefits from the program. Its interns are utilized to the fullest.
It ties in architecture, mechanical engineering, materials science, all that in one. Because you have to deal with the roadways, you have to communicate with the public. A lot of times the government plays a role in what you can and cannot do.
Civil engineers need to deal with issues like government regulation, environmental degradation, and the socioeconomic impact of major development projects. TRAC introduces students to these responsibilities early on. The course even includes a role-playing exercise where students study opposite sides of the development debate.
The kids actually act out the part of the different people in this town meeting, and they love it. And that's a lot of social studies in there.
As the world grows busier, more connected, and more populated, it's getting less predictable. Civil engineers and transportation experts are critical to sustain our remarkable quality of life.
Engineers that are retiring or leaving the field are not being replaced. So I would say for every two spots that become available, there's probably one engineer to fill them.
Getting the kids excited about the work world of transportation and civil engineering is what it's all about.
I didn't really think about it before this class, but now, like, you see dump trucks out there, our school's under construction, and hey, that's a piston and piston rod, and hey, that's torsion or whatever, and
just, you notice it more.
Yeah.
The goal is to develop students' ideas about engineering today. Students learn because practical experiments get them to care about the world they live in. With TRAC in the classroom, we can count on our young people to keep us moving in the future.
It's neat for us to be able to experiment with new, like, high-tech things and see how it works and why it works and ways we can maybe think of to make it better.
Yeah, if I could get to know more about it in this class and maybe with doing more modules, then I think it should be a career I'd like to pursue.
Definitely the knowledge and experience I learned from the TRAC program and be able to work in a team like that in a work environment gave me the head start I needed to really see what civil engineering is about.